Hello, hello. Welcome to this episode of Hearty Tips with Silke. Today, I'm going to share five ways to paint for less. Yay! Now, if you've been wanting to paint more or get started, and you're looking for ways to get art supplies for less, this is for you. Now, if you've already started painting, but you know the cost of living is just squeezing things a little bit, and you want to keep painting, this is also for you. Now, a lot of people, they make the mistake of thinking that art supplies are expensive and that you need a lot of them before you get started. Am I right? The problem is, if you're thinking this, it actually puts a bit of a mental barrier in front of you, and it stops you ever getting art supplies. And so your dream of painting just stays a dream. And if you've never painted before, you end up missing out on ever finding out how much fun painting can be, and that real sense of achievement and satisfaction you feel when you create something beautiful, what I call the art buzz. And you miss all the other benefits as well: relaxation, confidence building, concentration, stress relief, all of the good stuff. So you miss all of that if you're thinking and you've blocked your mind that arty is expensive. So today I just wanted to break some of those myths and barriers. And I wanted to share some tips with you that my paint club members and I have been using to save money on art supplies so you can still enjoy all the fun of painting and getting creative. Yay. So hi, for all of those of you who don't know me, I'm Silke. I'm founder of Heart for Art and also my signature Fast Results Painting Membership for New Artists Paint Club. Essentially, I help aspiring artists learn to paint, paint with confidence and joy, and create beautiful art. So give me a yes in the comments if you're keen to learn some money-saving tips for art supplies. Now, the reason I'm sharing this today is I was just reading today about the cost of living going up another 7.7% in the last year. So I just wanted to share some extra tips with my members, with my membership community, just to help them if they're feeling the pinch as well. And I thought, well, this is actually useful wider than just my members. I often share lots of extra stuff in there, but today I'm going to share it with you as well, because I think everybody should be able to access art and painting and all the goodness that comes with it. Now, I am half Dutch, if you don't know me, on my mum's side. And it's well known that the Dutch are, you know, they're known for bargaining and finding the best deals. Now, I don't think that's a bad thing, especially, you know, in the current economic times. And I think it actually goes back to the golden ages when Dutch, you know, the Dutch were traders and they wanted to get the best deals for their business. So, you know, it's kind of stuck with them, and I've inherited that trait as well. And I think personally for me, it's not just about saving money. Sometimes it's also the thrill of the hunt for a bargain as well, which actually reminds me, I remember my mum once, she rang me up once, and I don't think she'll mind me sharing this. She rang me up once to see if I wanted some slat blinds, because she'd found some that were just an amazing deal, but she didn't need any herself. So she rang me to see if I needed any, because she just really wanted to buy them because they were such an amazing bargain. That's just the super Dutch happening. I didn't actually need the slat blinds anyway, and she didn't buy them, but she really wanted to because it was such an amazing bargain. So yes, we as Dutch, we're really good at finding bargains, and I wanted to just share some of those with you today of what I've learned. I don't think she'd mind me sharing that story with you. Now, she wouldn't have considered them, buying them at all, those blinds, if they were full price. All right, which brings me back to thinking about art supplies are expensive. Yes, they can be expensive, but they can also not be expensive depending where you shop and what you're shopping for. Now, if you could spend less on art supplies and still have everything you need to paint great art, you'd be more inclined to get them, wouldn't you? Just like my mum, just you'd be more inclined to buy them, wouldn't you? Let me know if you agree. And let me tell you how you can, all right? Now, everything I'm going to share with you today, I actually have for you in a handy PDF right here, that I give away for free. I want everybody to benefit from it, and I'll tell you how to get that at the end. Now, I've already hinted at tip number one. Tip number one is don't shop at boutique art stores. All right. No offense against those boutique art stores. They're beautiful, amazing places, and they're so great. I love just going and having a look at all the stuff they've got, but they are expensive. All right. And the truth is that you can get many of those exact same supplies that they have, the same brand, the same exact product, at department stores. You know, like in New Zealand, for example, Warehouse Stationery or Spotlight. I think in Australia it's Target, but shops like that, they stock the same things, but for way less. All right. They're exactly the same product, same brand, same everything. They just have a much lower price tag when you shop at a department store compared to the boutique art shops. All right. Emporium shops as well. Like here in Wellington, we have Uncle Bill's and Uncle Pete's. I know in Whangarei they have Arthur's Emporium. Any of those kinds of shops often have the exact same brushes. That's a pencils, brushes, the exact same brushes. But again, for like some of them are like a quarter of the price, sometimes even a tenth of the price, depending on what you're buying. So, you know, I share a few more places to get better deals in the PDF that I'm going to share with you. You can grab that on my website. But yes, tip number one, don't shop at the expensive boutique shops. Check out the department stores and emporium shops. Way better prices, exact same products, way better prices. Tip number two, don't get the professional grade materials. Student grade materials is fine. All right. The quality is really good and will get you great results, especially if you're starting out. Even if you've been painting for years, you don't need the professional grade stuff. Unless you're selling your paintings for thousands of dollars, you just don't need the professional grade stuff, all right? The student grade stuff is fine, and it's a whole lot cheaper than the professional stuff. But don't avoid going for the kids stuff, though, because that's usually not the greatest quality at all. And you're not going to be able to do as much with it, all right? Now, the student grade stuff is what I use for all of my painting tutorials in my classes, and it's really high quality stuff. So tip two, don't get the professional grade stuff. Go for the student grade stuff. It is absolutely fine for what you want to do, all right? Tip number three is only get what you need. You don't need one of every brush or every single paint color, all right? Just start with a few. I've included the basic ones in the PDF that I'm going to share with you at the end, how to get it. You can start with basically a few brushes, you know, three or four brushes and a few paint colors. Even just the three primary colors, red, yellow, and blue, and black and white, is enough to get started on, all right? So that's only a few brushes and five paint colors. And if you look out for brush and paint sets, they're usually cheaper than buying individual brushes as well, and you can still get some really good quality brushes, okay? So tip three was only get what you need. Don't think you have to get everything, okay? You can always get one more brush here and there or one more paint color here and there if you want, but you can start with the basics. Tip number four, if you want to paint for less, don't paint on framed canvases. Now, I teach all my paintings on framed canvases, and by that I mean they've got a frame on the back of them so you can hang them straight on the wall. You can paint on these if you want. That said, department stores often, and emporium shops like Spotlight, for example, often have packs of 5 or 10 that are super low value, you know, super low value and still good quality. Just check their triple primed. I've included some extra tips about that in here. But yeah, the other option to paint on something else for way less is like canvas boards. I didn't grab one, but it's essentially canvas on a board. It's a whole lot cheaper than a canvas on a frame, but you can also paint on art pads. Now, these are awesome. I love these because it's canvas. It's just not on a frame. So it's literally the same canvas that would be on the frame, but it's in a pad. So you get a whole pad of them. This one has 10 sheets, and I think I paid $10 for it. This is A4. So that's like a dollar per masterpiece. How cool is that? They come in lots of different sizes, different number of sheets. This sheet's also got, this one's also got 10, and you can get them right up to A3, and they're much, much cheaper than painting on framed canvases. So that's a really amazing way. I know a lot of my paint club members do that. It's just a really good way to get more practice in without, you know, spending too much on framed canvases, and it means you can paint more for a whole lot less. All right. Tip number 5 is go op shopping. All right. Now, if you're watching anywhere else in the world, we call it op shopping, as an opportunity shopping, also known as secondhand shopping or thrift shopping. My mum and I absolutely love op shopping together. It's one of our favorite things to do together, just to go, and we don't even usually have a shopping list. We just go and see what we can find, what bargains we can get. We love going through the secondhand shops. It's so cool. And I love it too, because there is already so much stuff in the world. I believe it's better to reuse what's already there if we can. So just because someone else doesn't want it, you might, you know, what is it? One man's junk is another man's treasure. Now, I'm not just raving because I love op shopping with my mum. You know, and while we're op shopping, I'm always looking out for art supplies. There are so many people, they try their hand at painting and give up way too easily. Obviously, because they haven't found paint club, or they get given art supplies as a gift or something, and they don't ever use them. So they'll take them to the op shops and the secondhand shops, and so you can so often find brand new brush sets and paint sets, you know, or stuff that's hardly been used, and remarkably blank canvases. I found so many blank canvases at secondhand shops, you know, all sorts of different sizes. These are all the ones I do my free tutorials on. They're all pretty much sourced from op shops, secondhand shops. So I'm always on the lookout for those. And often they have an art section as well in the secondhand shop. So look out for those. So tip number 5 is go op shopping. Go to those secondhand stores and thrift stores and have a look for the art supplies there. There's always something there. Colour pencils as well. There's always colour pencils. And an extra tip number 6. I said there were 5, but there is actually 6. You can also repurpose already painted on canvas. All right. Either your own. If you've got a canvas, like I paint over mine all the time and reuse them. You just paint white over the top and you can reuse it, or gesso over the top and you can reuse it. But in secondhand shops, they always have paintings on canvases hanging on the walls, and you can often get them for super cheap. And all you have to do is paint over it with white paint or gesso, and you have a blank canvas again. All right. Again, so this one here, for example, I can see there's another painting underneath it, my little kingfisher. This is one that I think I paid $1 for it, painted white over the top of it, and I have a brand new white blank canvas to use. Now, you can use white paint or gesso. Gesso is an art-specific primer for canvas, but you can use white paint or even house paint as well. All right. Now, if you'd like to know a little bit more about repurposing canvas, I did a video on my blog. Go to heartforart.co.nz and go up to the menu and click on blog, and then look for the one, do a search for how to save money recycling canvas. All right. So that'll tell you what to look for. There are a few tips you need to look out for on that one. So go and have a look for that. Hi, Brenda. Brenda's here. She says, I'm looking forward to painting bubble painting party. Love going to Lincroft or Spotlight too. I've not heard of, is it Lincraft? Lincraft, that must be specific to your area. But see, there's lots of places that have stuff much, much cheaper. I'm looking forward to painting bumbles too, by the way. It's going to be fun. There it is right behind me. And if you'd like to know more, so that's, go and have a look on my blog for how to save money recycling canvas. And if you'd like to know more about painting over your canvases, on the blog as well, heartforart.co.nz, check blog in the menu and search for how to gesso canvas. And I talk through how to do that and the different types of paint you can use as well. Like I said, there are a few things to check for if you're buying other people's canvases to repurpose, which I cover in that blog as well. Hi, Charmaine. Oh, she loves op shopping too. Op shops are fantastic, aren't they? They're a gold mine for artists. They absolutely are. So there's five tips. Well, actually six, five plus one for how to paint for less. So let me know if you found that helpful and which tip you found most helpful. And if there's anyone else you know who would find that helpful too, please do pass it on to them as well. All right. So summing up the five tips for how to paint for less. Number one is don't shop at the boutique art shops. All right. They charge way more for the exact same products that you can get in the department stores and emporium shops. So go shop there instead. Tip two, don't get the professional grade material. It's just not necessary. Student grade is fine, but do avoid the kids stuff. That's not quite the good quality stuff. Tip number three, only get what you need. Just get a few brushes. You don't need all the every kind of brush, although I kind of look like I have got all of them. And you don't need every paint color either. In fact, if you get less color, just get the primary colors. It'll actually teach you, you'll learn how to mix colors better because you won't have the colors. So you'll have to learn to mix them. So just start with a few of those. Tip number four, if you want to paint for less, don't paint on framed canvases. Use something else. You can use canvas boards or, like I showed you, the canvas pads are awesome for painting on as well. Imagine what you could do and how much you could save painting on pads, canvas pads instead. Tip number five, what was tip number five? Op shopping. Go op shopping, thrift shopping, secondhand shopping, whatever it's called in your country, go to those. There are always people who have been given art supplies and don't want them, and they take them to the op shops. And tip number six, extra tip, look out for canvases there as well. There's always blank canvases to find, but you can find ones that have already been painted on, paint over them, and you've got another brand new blank canvas. Yay. So, as I mentioned, everything that I've just talked about, that I've just shared with you today, is a handy downloadable PDF. There's a few pages in here for you. So the next step, if you'd like to paint for less and get my tips, is to head over to my website and grab that. So heartforart.co.nz. Now, this is on the homepage. Just scroll down a little bit and you'll see the new artist complete shopping. What is it? Complete supply list and shopping guide. So it's my free shopping list of basically the basic must-have art supplies, and I've included loads of tips on where to shop for best prices, and it'll really help you get your art supplies for way less, and also help you avoid wasting money on the wrong art materials as well if you're not sure what to get. This list is going to make buying your art supplies and getting set up with the right materials so quick and easy, and it's going to save you money. All right. So you can grab my free shopping list now on my website. Just head over to heartforart.co.nz. There's the address there on the screen. Actually, I think I included it. It could be included in the post as well. I may have included the whole link straight to it in the post as well. But if you go to my website, it's on the home page there. Look for the free art supply list and shopping guide, and then click on that and pop your details in the form, and you'll get a link straight to your inbox to download it straight away. You could have it within minutes and then start dreaming about where you're going to shop and what you're going to get. Yay. And there's actually extra tips and more in there that I didn't cover today. So there's lots of useful information to help you get painting for less, and just get painting at all. Yay. Because painting is good for you. So if you enjoyed this episode of Hearty Tips with Silke, and you'd like more helpful art tips and tutorials on all sorts of stuff, make sure to also get on my mailing list, all right? Click the bar at the top of the website on the homepage, and you can join there. And if you've already got your art supplies, but you haven't quite used them yet, maybe they're gathering dust, or just you're not sure what to paint, you want someone to show you step by step how to create a beautiful painting from start to finish in only a few hours, then go check out Paint Club. All right. It's Paint Club is just you get step by step guidance, and you get support to get started, and all the tips and tutorials to help you create those beautiful paintings, and there's an awesome community of like-minded people to learn with, all just inspiring and encouraging and cheering each other along. So go check that out, Paint Club. You guessed it, it's on heartforart.co.nz. Scroll down a little bit and you'll see Paint Club. Click the link and you'll see everything that's included and all the amazing benefits and things you can enjoy and what you'll learn and all the amazing stuff that is in Paint Club. And right now, you can actually get the entire library of over 30 paintings absolutely free when you join. In fact, all of the ones that you can see behind me and so many more. Yep, the horse too. What's over there? Can't see that one. They're all in there waiting for you. You can get started straight away. Yay! You get them all free when you join. They're the whole back catalogue of every painting I've ever taught in Paint Club. So you get all those free when you join. So you can get started straight away and have your first finished painting in only a few hours. That's all it takes. Yay! So I hope that was helpful. Thanks for watching today. I hope what I shared inspired you to paint, because painting makes me feel good, and I'd love to share that with you as well. I'd love you to feel that joy and the healing of art. So thanks for joining me. Don't forget to like, share, and follow, and subscribe. If you're watching on YouTube, click the little subscribe button and the bell thing to get notifications. And I hope you'll come back to hear more tips and strategies on how to live your most creative, happy life. Hope to paint with you soon. Cheers. Bye.